Hey guys, I am Venkat, and in this video, we'll discuss one of the common SQL interview questions. Write a SQL query to select the most repeated column value. In this students table, we have only one column, the name column, and the most repeated value in this column is Tom, because this name is repeated twice. So we want to write a SQL query that selects this value. If you understand group by in SQL, this query is very easy to write. After you answer this question, the interviewer may ask the following related question as well to check your understanding of group by and having. Write a SQL query to find a value that is repeated n number of times. That is maybe 5 times, 10 times, 1 million times, who knows. Again, the key to answer these questions is understanding group by and having in SQL. If you're new to these two concepts, please check out this video. I'll have the link available in the description box below this video. Here is the SQL script to create and insert test data into students table. Again, I'll have the script available in the description box below this video. Now, we want to write a SQL query that selects the most repeated student name. At the moment, in our students table, as you can see, we've got 4 rows, and Tom is the most repeated column value. So we want to write a SQL query that selects name column from students table. Now, in the select list, along with the name of the student, I also want the number of times each student name is repeated. For that, in the select list, along with the name column, let's also use SQL Server aggregate function count. And then we can either specify star here or the name of the column by which we are counting. In our case, we are counting by the name column. So let's use the column name to keep it more meaningful. But keep in mind, we can either use star or the name of the column. It doesn't really matter. And let's give this column an alias, total repetitions. At this point, let's execute this query and see what happens. We have an error. Why? Well, that's because by using this count function, we're asking SQL Server to count the number of times each student name is repeated. And for SQL Server to be able to do that, it has to first group the rows by name column. Let me actually explain what I mean. First, let's select all the rows that we have in the students table. Now, for SQL Server to be able to count how many times each student name is repeated, it has to group these rows that we have in the students table by the name column. So in the group Sarah, we only have one repetition, and in the group Tom, we have 2 repetitions because this name is repeated twice, and in the group Mike, we have 1 repetition. So to be able to tell SQL Server to group these rows by the name column, we use group by. By which column we want to group by? By the name column. Let's execute this query now. There we go. By looking at this output, we can say Tom is the most repeated name. But then in the output, we don't want all these groups. We just want this one group. So for that, let's sort the result set by the total repetitions column. So let's use order by, and we want to order by total repetitions column in descending order. Let's execute this query again. Notice now in the result set, we have the group with the highest repetitions at the top. And in the result, we want just this one row. So for that, in the select list, include top one. There we go. In the output, we have the name that is repeated most number of times. But then, wait a minute. In the output, we don't want this total repetitions column. We just want the name value that is repeated most number of times. Well, let's see what's going to happen if we drop this total repetitions column from the select list. Let's execute the query again. An error, invalid column name, total repetitions. Why? Well, that's because SQL Server doesn't know what this total repetitions column is. Why? Well, that's because we just deleted that column. To fix this, instead of using the column alias total repetitions, let's use this expression directly. So order by count of name descending, and we don't want this column in our select list. Delete that and execute the query. There we go. Just the name of the student that's repeated most number of times. Now, let me insert this name Sarah 3 more times into the students table. Select the data again. Now, Sarah is the most repeated name. So if we execute our query, we should get Sarah. There we go. Now, what if the interviewer asks you another follow-up question? Write a SQL query to find the student name that is repeated exactly 2 times. Well, again, as I said before, if we understand group by and having this query is very easy to write. Now, one important point to keep in mind. In SQL, to filter groups, we use having and not the where clause. So, in place of this order by, let's use having. Count of name equals to. Why 2? Well, because we want the name that is repeated exactly 2 times. There we go. The name Tom is repeated 2 times and we see it in the output. Now, what if you want all the names that are repeated 2 times? Well, for that, simply remove this top 1 keyword from the select list. If you want a student name that is repeated exactly 4 times, then instead of 2, include 4 here. There we go. We have Sarah's name, which is repeated 4 times. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.